Tech Cocktail Conversations, candid insights from startup founders, entrepreneurs, and thought leaders from around the globe.
My name is Leah Buskey. I'm the founder and CEO of TaskRabbit. TaskRabbit is an online marketplace where people can go to outsource small jobs and tasks to others in their neighborhood. So if you need dry cleaning picked up or groceries delivered, you can go online to TaskRabbit, name the price you're willing to pay, and we have a network of hundreds of background check TaskRabbits in your neighborhood ready to help. So my inspiration for TaskRabbit actually started with my 100-pound yellow lab named Kobe. And at the time, I was a software engineer at IBM. And my husband and I, we were sitting at home one night. We were getting ready to go out to dinner. We had called a cab to come pick us up and take us across town when we realized we were out of dog food. And Kobe, being 100 pounds, really loves to eat. He can't miss a meal. And so we thought, wouldn't it be nice if there was just a place online we could go, say we needed dog food, name the price we're willing to pay. We're certain that there was someone in our own neighborhood that'd be willing to help us out. Maybe even someone at the store at that very second, and it was just a matter of connecting with them. And so that's where the original inspiration for TaskRabbit happened. 4 months later, I decided to quit my job at IBM and build the first version of the site. We've seen so many fun use cases for TaskRabbit. So there's the practical, you know, handyman services, house chores, grocery deliveries, but then the really crazy and wild ones as well. We had someone post on TaskRabbit, a man actually, hired a TaskRabbit to stand on the Brooklyn Bridge with a sign that said, "I heart Ella," in a bouquet of flowers. And he knew that his wife would be walking home on the bridge that night from work, and he wanted to surprise her. And so that was just a really cute use case, a creative use of TaskRabbit, and the TaskRabbits love getting really fun tasks like that. So when I first started TaskRabbit, I bootstrapped it for about the first 18 months that we existed. And as an engineer, I actually didn't know that much about fundraising or investors or how all of that worked. And so I had to learn a lot. And I went out for my first round of funding about 12 months after the site was launched. So I had really good data and metrics to share. I participated in an incubator program that Facebook was running in the summer of 2009 out in Palo Alto. And at the end of that program, there's a big demo day that all these investors came to learn about what these startups were doing. And that's when I met my first seed round of investors. So Ann Mirico from Floodgate Fund led that round and ended up being a $1.8 million seed. And from there, we've just really snowballed. We raised a Series A last year, a Series B in December, and now we're sort of on this track for high growth and expansion and just continuing to build the business. I very much went from being an engineer into becoming an entrepreneur, and that was a long road, and there was a lot of things that I needed to learn. And I think the key for me was finding early mentors, advisors, that could help early on fill in the holes. And very much, you know, I felt like in the early days as an engineer, I didn't really understand what was ahead of me. I felt like I was working in this black box, and I didn't really know what was coming next. But in talking to, you know, critical mentors and advisors, they were able to shed some light into that box for me and help me learn quickly all the processes and steps I needed to go through to raise money and talk to investors and, you know, what a pitch deck was. And so my advice for engineers or really anyone starting a business is just surround yourself with great people that you really trust that you can learn quickly from. So the biggest lesson I've learned is to always trust your instincts and trust your gut on things. And so as an engineer, I had to learn a lot about fundraising and business planning and forecasting and all those things. But you also have to give yourself enough credit to trust your own instincts. And your gut calls that you're gonna make are gonna be what makes or breaks your business. So you have to be able to trust yourself and have enough confidence in your own decisions to move the business forward.